Now we're going to go ahead and take a look at the code for defining an entity. Let's imagine that you want to store entities of kind recipe. Maybe you like chocolate cake, especially chocolate cake covered in strawberries and sprinkles. Or maybe you prefer pavlova. This one looks really good with kiwis and strawberries. But whatever kind of cake you like, your recipe needs some properties. Obviously, it has to have a name, a list of ingredients, some instructions, perhaps indicate the number of servings, and you could say whether it's vegetarian or not. This might not be quite so important for cakes, but could be really important for, like, say, lasagna. If you use the native App Engine Data Store low-level Java API, you need to create entities as instances of the entity class. However, the entity class is final, so you can't subclass it, and you can't add fields to it. Fortunately for us, there's an open source library called Objectify. Objectify makes it easier to work with entities by allowing you to define classes that represent entities of a particular kind. Then you simply add fields to the class for each property that you want your entities to have. So, here's the code for the recipe entity class. Notice the imports. These packages provide the Objectify functionality for defining entities. Okay, next, notice this @entity annotation. This annotation indicates that this class represents an entity. The class name is the kind of the entity. So here we're defining entities of kind recipe. This entity class has the properties recipe ID, name, vegetarian, servings, and so on. When you use Objectify, every entity class must have one and only one property marked with the @ID annotation. This is the entity's ID and it's used to help uniquely identify the entity. You see that the rest of this class is just a regular old Java class. It could have more constructors and methods if you wanted.